XProtect VMS is a suite of powerful open platform IP video management software products optimized for companies of all sizes to quickly identify and respond to incidents. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to navigate the management client. This is the management client interface with a typical configuration. The content might vary and look slightly different in your organization depending on product version, profile, and the configuration. The site navigation pane is your main navigational element in the management client. The features are grouped in a hierarchical structure and categorized to reflect the functionality of the software. We'll demonstrate a simple task that will introduce you to navigating the user interface and using the panes. We are going to turn off video motion detection on the East parking camera because we use it only for live viewing. Click the Servers node to expand it. Then click Recording Servers. The Overview pane provides an overview of the element you have selected in the site navigation pane. In this case, you see the one recording server in this installation. When you select an element in the Overview pane, it typically displays the properties in the Properties pane. When you right-click elements in the Overview pane, you get access to the management features. Click the plus sign to expand the Acme Administration node. Here, you see the hardware items that are connected to the recording server named Acme Administration. Click East Parking to expand it. Click the Panasonic camera so we can configure its properties. Now we have content in all panes. The Properties pane displays the properties of the element you selected in the Overview pane, in this case, a camera. The properties are distributed on several dedicated tabs. The Preview pane at the bottom appears when you work with devices and recording servers. It shows preview images from the selected camera or shows information about the state of the device. Now, let's disable motion detection for this camera. Click the Motion tab in the Properties pane. On the Motion tab, you can enable, disable, and adjust motion detection settings for the current camera. Click the checkbox to clear it and disable motion detection. That's it. Remember to always save your changes. In each pane menu, you can define how you want the pane to appear. You can either hide, auto-hide, or undock a pane to make it a floating pane. Let's undock the site navigation pane so we can move it to a new position. Click Floating. You have now undocked the pane. It can be moved to a secondary display or docked to a new position within the client. Let's dock it on the right side of the client. The system will indicate when you can release the pane. You can also auto-hide a pane by clicking the pin icon in the pane's menu bar. This may free some space if you're using a single display. As a last option, you can completely hide a pane, but I don't recommend doing that. Let's return to the default layout before we continue. In the menu bar, click View. Click Reset Application Layout. After a restart of the management client, the default layout will be restored. Let's look at the Options dialog box. From here, you can specify settings related to the general appearance, behavior, and functionality of the system. In this example, we want the VMS to automatically send out email notifications on certain occasions. To prepare the system for that, we need to connect the VMS to a mail server. Click Tools to open the Options dialog box. Click Options. The Options dialog box is arranged with several tabs where you can manage a range of system settings. Actually, you assign most of the default system settings in this box. For example, if you don't want motion detection to be enabled by default when you add new cameras, you can disable it here. Your task now is to connect to a mail server. Click the Mail Server tab. In the Mail Server settings, you need to enter a couple of details to allow the VMS to connect to the mail server. We already received the settings from the system administrator. Let's insert the mail server settings. Click OK to apply the settings and close the Options dialog box. You just saw how to navigate the management client. Visit our YouTube site to view other tutorials in this playlist.